Hello farmers, and welcome back to Let's Play Farming Simulator 15 on Gumstein. Can I pronounce that right? But anyways, you're back after a little bit of a too long of a break. Sorry, it's been a little bit busy here, but anyways, you're back again. So just looking at the dimension on the tires. But yeah, I was like, first I think, wait, is that the same size we got? No, it's not. Anyway, sorry about that. Yeah, so we are back. Haven't been doing too much on here. I can't really remember what I've done off camera, but I know the straw and everything is done. So yeah. For this episode, I'm going to do some tillage and technically sowing as well. I think we can do everything in one go. I was thinking in the beginning that we should plow. I did actually try to plow a little bit, and then I saw, you know, the high worker won't really work too well on the fields, so that's why the plow is over there now. I haven't touched the cultivator or the seeder yet, but as well, I was thinking cultivator and then seed, but that would take so long, and I'm quite sure these seeders still don't cultivate. Because you're technically these rotors underneath here are mostly to even out the furrows from the cultivator, if I don't remember wrong. So, come to the conclusion that we test something we haven't really used before in any more videos, except that maybe I spotlighted it once, I think. Is this Lemken, the AgroVision company? Yeah, the. Our chat C8 requires 110 horsepower, so yeah, 3 meter wide, same size as the sorry about that, as the cedar. So, and it's only 7 grand, nearly 8 really. Well, yeah, we buy that. How would I do this? I think I will put it on the front. Yeah, I think so. Because you technically can put it on the back as well and then the seed there. But I think this tractor will do a wheelie if you do that. So the seeder goes on the back and the cultivator on the front. If you don't do a wheelie on the way down there. And the seeds are back here, I think. Yeah, so gold coin here, nice. As well, I saw another gold coin off camera that I decided I will show you folks. So one back here, so yeah, I think one of the goals as well is to find all the gold coins on this map. Hopefully I will find most of them on camera. I think I took a few off camera, but I think it was all the way in the beginning. Not quite sure. Oh, okay. We don't have any traction on the front. That's a problem. Oh, come on, make the turn. Oh my goodness. I don't really want to carry the weight down either, so. I just gear down and hopefully it goes well. Don't know what's up with my voice right now, but anyways, if you don't notice anything, if not, well, then everything is good. But yeah, let's talk about what I've been doing lately. So last weekend, at the end of the week really, I was on the Agrotechnic. I did write like quite quickly just on Facebook on the way and really who's going back then, but I forgot to make a video and stuff like that. But anyways, I don't know how many that went there on the Agrotechnic last. Not this weekend I was, but you know, the previous one in November, last weekend in November, you folks that were there, you know. But yeah, you can please comment down below if you was there, if any Norwegian people or from other countries was in Norway and on that place. I was over there and had a great time. was a lot of things to see, basically. A lot of new tractors and stuff. I have a few pictures and videos and stuff like that. Nothing too fancy, but a little bit so you can see different tractors. At least some of them. But as well, maybe I can link down below, you know, different places that have some more videos and photos and stuff like that of the place, so you can see the whole place. Because I don't have too many of those. Switch direction. Yes. Oh yeah, really that easy. Oh, just realized how it's connected. Okay, so basically just screw out those bolts right there and then turn them and screw them back in. Yeah. Should wish that was that quickly, like this in real life. Press a button and I'll change. Probably not a fun job changing all of those. But hey. Probably not the worst job either. But okay. Should we do a headland first? Think so. The manual headland. I do have both cosplay and technically all the tractor installed, but all the tractor doesn't work correctly for me, so kind of giving up on all the tractor, and don't really think I would use cosplay for this. I do want to see it. Should I take canola? Yeah. I'm just gonna do the headlamp basically. I just realized there's a cultivator on the front and it will. This is a pain. This is gonna be a pain in the rear. Yeah, basically, yeah. This is gonna not be fun. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay. I'll put you on your mirror. Oh, no. Not all the tractor. Turn off all the tractor. Now you can go. Please don't make a mess. Please don't get stuck. I'm saying that and I know it will get stuck because it's a fence and other things down there. If we go that way, we have a forest. If I make a headland, I'm just gonna cultivate it up with the. Okay, you can drive through that. Then he stopped. Brilliant. Great. Oh no. This is very tempting right now to just sell all of this and just buy a completely new drill, because this is not gonna work. No, this is not gonna work. Yeah, it's a nice cultivator and everything, it's a nice concept, but it's definitely I managed to get me straight in where he was earlier, and because it's cultivating, he doesn't care and he just makes a mess. Don't think it will. Maybe it'll turn around. Not sure. Oh, yeah. Now you're gonna go straight into that. Yeah, okay, fine. I see what you mean. This doesn't work. It will work if I drive, but I kinda want to do some other things as well to play around with today. And I don't really have the time to see the whole field if you're gonna make, you know, a lot of episodes. And I don't think you guys gonna watch sit and watch me do all of that. So, and it's the easy way then. Worth a try, right? Worth a try. Because I wasn't quite sure if I really wanted to go big-ish in the beginning. But the only solution I can see is the Vardar Star drill. It'll make the most sense here. And make the efficiency quite good. So let's do that. It's in here. Because I think it's just the best fall there was, really. Yes. Oh. 52. And I'm in here. Nice. Excellent. Let's see. Garage. Get 4 grand for you. Probably nearly 5 if I come down here with you. Probably 8 or 9 for you. No. Mr. Bankman, can I borrow some money from you? I know you always borrow me some money. There we go. You pay that back later. Where am I going? I guess we do this. I'm crazy today. Okay, let's buy that. So I'm not doing this. Fail. Oh my goodness. You know, this is the reason I don't record videos these days. In the middle of the week. Oh my goodness. Okay. See there? Stay away from me now. I don't want anything more to do. Oh, I have to. Oh my goodness. Sorry. Okay. Try that again. Click on you. Boy. Yes. Thanks. So that was a waste of money. It's not often I do that mistake, but of course it has to happen when I record. Brilliant. But anyways. Okay. I have to go back to... It's a productive day today. You get to do so much. But anyways, I think we can go back to talking about the... aggro technique. That I was on. So, for you folks that have been there, of course you know what tractors and everything. I was there, but for you folks that haven't, I will upload a video maybe this week or the weekend, I'm not too sure. On the different photos and the small videos that I recorded. The videos is mostly just inside the tractors. There's just so many people, you know, I don't like recording people. Especially probably doesn't do too much, but I don't really like it, so I'll just do a quick around in some of the tractors. Some tractors I did quite quick because, you know, some of them are a little bit big and, you know, people want to sit in them. As I need a bloody queue outside. It's gonna have to be a little bit quick, you know. Didn't crash, but yeah, I have to be a little bit quick. So not all of them are great, but they're alright. That's why you get to see, you know, how the tractors are inside and stuff like that. So yeah, I think a lot of them actually are stepless tractors for whatever reason. Some of them are power shift, maybe some manual. I can't quite remember which tractors I recorded. I didn't record all of them because I didn't have the time. And I haven't been inside absolutely all of the tractors, but I've been inside quite a few of them. you know, looking around, see what, you know, the different competitions have. And I was showing my dad, and he was saying, you know, there's so much difference, you know, between the brands. You know, that's a problem, you know, owning, if you're going to own more than one brand, you know. If you're going to drive them all the time as well, they're going to be... It's not fun, to say at least, because different manufacturers has a tendency to, you know, has a, you know, want to have their own type of systems and their own way to control stuff, and yeah. So it's a lot of differences, even these the stepless transmissions, but I haven't really, you know, tried the different steplesses, except for only ones I've driven is the CVT front, is the it's a command from New Holland, Case IH, CVX, and Valtra Direct. Looks like the new Directs are a little bit better now, because they're set up a little bit better, as far as I can see. Because certain things seems to be simplified and stuff like that. Plus the cab is stopped being better as well. Because when you're thinking about Valtra, I haven't actually been the best on the Luxus front, really. Good tractors, but aren't. Comfort and function wise, they aren't really great. But reliability wise, they're quite good. But I don't think the direct ones are as reliable as the power shift and normal ones, really, normal transmissions. But hey, they're alright, you know. But I still have to try a Valtra Direct versus Auto Commander CVX case transmission. I'd rather go for the CVX or the Auto Command. Preferably the Auto Command so far, because I like some of the features that New Holland has. I was discussing this with a case seller, because you know the dealers up here, of course, sell both brands. I was going inside them. Okay, four-wheel drive on then. I was going inside one of the cases, and it was a CVX. It was a Max, yeah. I was sitting inside there, and was a seller comes into me and stuff like that, and I asked him, why isn't a monitor here? Because it, I haven't really seen too many stepless tractors without. I don't know if you folks want me to call it stepless or CVT. Maybe I should call it CVT. CVT transmissions or CVT tractors, whatever. That doesn't have a monitor. Except for the normal gauges, basically. So I was like, where's the monitor? And then he told me it was an option. I was like, okay. But so that's why you're showing this small tractor without it and the bigger ones with it. But it makes sense, you know, because, and as well, he told me that, you know, these smaller farmers don't really want the monitor, they don't need it, and stuff like that. It makes sense, but it looks a little bit strange to me, you know. But anyhow, we explained it, but I never seen Auto Command without the monitor. So he was saying maybe you could get them without it, he didn't know. But I have never seen one without the monitor, so please tell me if you ever seen a New Holland without the monitor on it, when it's stepless transmission or CVT transmission in it, the Auto Command. Because I haven't, so so I didn't know you could get them without it, but I've never seen one without the monitor. It was just the case fans that are not liking the monitors on the side. I don't know, a touch screen technically, but yeah, I don't know. But that was a little discussion me and the dealer had, why no monitors. But you know, when he told me it was an option, I was like, okay. But yeah, it was quite expensive as well to get though, so but yeah, I don't know, maybe it's cheaper when you buy the tractor and want it on it from the factory than aftermarket mounting it, I'm not sure. But anyways, as well, it was discussing a little bit, you know, in New Holland versus the Case, basically. You know, the tractors are very similar, except for transmissions and setup in the cab is a little bit different. Some people, of course, just say, you know, the two tractors are the same tractor, just different paint. But, of course, that's basically Steyr and Case. Those are two different, those are the exact same tractors, just in different paint. One is red and white, and the other one is just red, you know, and black a little bit. And in Holland, it's a little bit of a different machine, of course. I think the transmission and stuff like that, basics, are everything the same. I don't really think they have different transmissions that much, really, because when I was trying out the CVX, it acted just like the New Holland. Just was a little bit different to control the transmission. That's the only difference. It acted just the same, basically. I didn't feel any better driver comfort, or it was acting any different. I felt it was quite similar. So, yeah. But, you know, the stylish and the Case and stuff like that is quite different from the New Holland. New Holland is a lot simpler. Something the seller there didn't like. He liked, you know, more fancier look. For me, I like the more simpler look, because it's the tractor and I, you know, want to see all my controls easily. That's very important for me anyways. And that makes me relax as well in the cab, you know, everything. I know where everything is. Just a glance over it and I know where all the buttons is. Well, the basics anyways. Mostly in the Case as well, though it's not very difficult. I struggled more in the Valtra stuff, I don't know why, but stuff wasn't as logical and easy, really. But anyway, but the, you know, in the worst cases in New Holland, you know, it's a little bit of a taste, really, what you like. It's not that much different in the tractors anymore, I don't think. But, you know, he liked the nicer style inside the cab more than me, for example, and stuff. But I haven't really worked too much on Cases before, so can't really say too much. But in the small category of tractors, I definitely like the NH better. So, that's definitely true when it comes to the 3-point hitch management. That's definitely, I don't want anything in Case when it comes under 100 horsepower. Not even considerable. Because of the 3-point system. I quite like that on the New Holland. It's probably the same way as, you know, the system itself is probably the same, but how you control it, I quite like on the NH. So, yeah. But bigger, for now, New Holland. So that's what I like. Driven mostly with auto command. So, but we have to see. Maybe we can try some more Case as well on the CVX. But really, the two tractors are basically the same, except for, you know, looks and you know, a little bit how ergonomics and stuff like that. That's the main differences basically between the two. Engine, transmission, basics are the same, just controlled in a different way, and, you know, controlled in a different way inside the cab. But I think the transmission, technically itself, mechanically and everything, is the same. Engine, of course, back ends and everything is the same, but mostly in the cab, I think, is the difference between the two. That's really where I say, whatever you like, really. Don't think the other one will do any better than the other. Because of the paint, really. Just what you like to sit inside of. And sometimes, for whatever reason, the Case seems to be cheaper, but who knows. For whatever reason. I think that's a sales thing for Case, I don't know. Be a little bit cheaper than NH. Who knows. But anyways, the Case tractors that was there was the Maxim. They're called Maxim, right? The Case similar size as the T6. Maxim 130, I think it was. CVX without the monitor, as I told. Puma 165, I think. The new Puma. With the lights. It wasn't inside the 165. I think it was a 165. I don't think it was a 16. I think it was 165, the new ones. But don't quote me on that or whatever. Not quite sure, but I think so. And as well, there was a 240 or something like that, the biggest one, the Puma. As well, there was the new version with the new roof and stuff like that. I was inside the big Puma, so yeah. But I didn't really notice too many differences. You probably notice it mostly when you're out working with it, because the same as in New Holland, was some updates for the software and stuff like that, the GPS or whatever. But the light package is definitely nice. It's definitely nice. Unfortunately, New Holland didn't show up in any of the new T7s or T6s. It's a bit unfortunate, but I was as well told by the dealer that I wasn't supposed to, you know, take the brand. You know, New Holland was supposed to challenge Case and vice versa, basically. But both of them had a new Giants, though, the Optimum and the T7 HD. That's quite exciting, though. That's quite nice. But unfortunately, guys, I completely forgot about the Optimum because I was just looking at the T7. I actually forgot the. I only have one picture of the Optimum, so sorry about that. But technically, though, in the interior and stuff, everything is the same. I was inside the. I was seeing from the outside, it's the same. I was inside the T7 HD. I don't think I have any video from that, but it's basically the same as any other auto command. And the same with the Optimum, so. But I forgot to take pictures of the Optimum too much, but you can technically see them on the internet. I have some. A few pictures of the T7 HD. But the reason I struggled a little bit with these two tractors was, you know, people kind of like hanging around them. So it was always queues and stuff like that to get inside, so yeah. But anyways, both of those two were there. I didn't unfortunately look too much on the Case, but they look quite cool. Definitely a more compact tractor than a T8, I guess, because I've never been in a T8. But what I've seen in videos, they are more compact, these. Plus, they have no boost on them. There's a constant horsepower. So it's quite nice. There's no boost that just kicks in. It's constantly... I think the one is 270 and the other one is 300 or something. Not quite sure. But anyways, as well, I was told by a salesman that I was in the... what is the English name for that now? Where they produce Case tractors and Steyr tractors. What is the English name for that country? I know the Norwegian name, Österrike, but... But yeah, anyways. If you know where they are produced, it's that country that was up there with the Optimum and... 36 tons of something on a trailer, and they had a race, a little drag race nearly, versus that tractor versus a truck. But I'm not sure which truck it was, so I don't know how much horsepower and stuff like that was pulling or having, but it was apparently pulling the same weight, I think. And the Optimum would just fly straight by it up to 50 basically. It was so much torque in it that just gonna go. It just went to the dealer side. It was very cool to see. The same I was told by the salesman for the T7 HD at the place there. The other guy I talked with about the Optimum was at the dealership. So yeah. But yeah, two salesmen have been telling me that story. You know, the... the Optimum flying straight by a truck, basically, or at least accelerating a lot quicker up to its top speed. It's quite cool though, and thinking about trucks usually have a lot of horsepower. But as far as I know, I don't have the... Okay, you can't do that anymore. You don't have the torque as a tractor engine has. It's quite crazy, you know, how much torque it really is in these six cylinders. And I think it's a 6.7 liter twin turbo or something like that. Straight six, inline six, I mean, in the Optimum and T7. So it's quite impressive actually. Well, it pulls that well, really. 36 tons is quite a bit, plus you have a stepless transmission stealing horsepower. So yeah, well, apparently it wasn't too long either before you hit top speed, so as far as I was told. So yeah, it was quite cool to hear. So definitely, if you're looking for a strong tractor, they definitely seem to be fitting that bill quite nicely, and plus they are quite compact for the horsepower, really. Not too bad. Well, I think they nearly weigh like 10 tons or something like that. But hey, if you're gonna pull a lot of weight, I suppose you need a lot of weight. So it's probably a little bit over 10 tons they weigh. But yeah, quite cool tractors, both of them. And that one at the case, not the case, in New Holland, T7 HD was in a special silver coat or paint. Not really paint, but do you call that? I'm just gonna call it paint. But there's not really painting them, but you know. At least in a silver color, really. Quite cool. And as well with the leather seat and stuff like that. So it's quite cool tractor. So yeah. And the new looks on them as well is quite nice. I like them anyways. But hey, that was that. As well it was the other brands. It was Valtra, their biggest Valtra. I don't remember its number. And let's see how this slurry. Just gonna check. Klaas had their Xerion. Yes, that was their biggest tractor. John Deere had, oh, this is slurry petto, is over here. They had, what did I have? John Deere. An 8R or something like that? Okay, zero. Oh, it's another coin. Nice. They had 8R, I think. Just gonna check if we got any Fertilizer Brothers. Yes, we do. Where? Then here? What on earth is this? Oh, probably to run the auger thing. Yeah, okay, anyways, they had an 8R, I think, or something like that. As well, I think the new Forge Harvester was there as well. But you kind of can guess I didn't really look too much over there, John Deere. Not too much about John Deere, I didn't look over there for reasons, but I don't know. There were so many people that I didn't really care to try taking pictures. Because it was, oh my goodness, what did I just do? Look at this. Next episode, find all the bloody coins. That's next episode's job. So I don't like having all those coins there. But anyways. But yeah, I think they had the 8600i or whatever. The Forge Harvester. But I think the biggest tractor was an 8R or something like that. What else? Wait, can I fill the hair? No. Are you kidding me? You gotta be funny. I really don't have a filling place for this. Oh, maybe I do. See a blue thing. It's always a good thing. Oh yeah. Don't know how, why you're filling from a liquid tank up in a pellet spreader, but hey, I can't say anything. I should probably use the manual filling, but I don't think I have a bucket right now to accept fertilizer. But yeah, I'm trying to still think a little bit on that algo technique, but I think I'm gonna make two videos of that, one without me talking and the other one maybe with me explaining the different tractors. You folks can comment down below. I'm probably just gonna make in this week, probably just put together the you know, without me talking over the video kind of thing, and then maybe if it's an interest for it, me sit and talk over the video, so we can, you know, explain things and stuff like that. I don't know really. Just gonna take this coin. Good, because it's there, that's why. So yeah, I think I'm gonna explain more in that video about the Ogre technique, because I can't really remember all the tractors right now and everything. It's probably better to explain when I have pictures and stuff like that to talk about. So yeah. What else is it to talk about now? Not quite sure. Maybe I can be quiet for a little bit then. Trying to kill me. Okay, people. You know the accelerator pedal? You press that a little bit harder, you go faster. You know? No, you don't? Okay. I go off here then. Stupid people. I'm looking forward to when I actually can slurry this and everything. It's proper job. Probably need to plow as well then. Probably won't, but because I don't really have the time. I don't know why I said but anyways. Yeah. It should be quick. I think we're just gonna end off after this. And then we'll do the next episode. Not sure. Figure that out in the next episode. Maybe I'll fast forward and we do another harvest. Or are we gonna run out and try to find all the bloody coins? A coin finding episode. Maybe we'll do that next episode. It's quite, you know, it done a proper job though. Put them around nicely. So maybe try to find them and see if we get any bonuses on this map to find all the coins. Because I have not tested it. And if you have, if you're watching this video and you have already tried that, please don't spoil it for me. I really want to test it myself. So yeah. I really, really want to see what's gonna happen, if it happens anything at all. But yeah, what else is really to talk about? Oh yeah, that's well with this tractor, since we're driving this right now. I actually learned something new when I was on Ogre Technique. I was in a case, Farmer U Pro. And that's while I was talking, you know, to a salesman and stuff like that. I was was really going the case versus the T5 then. You know, I quite like the T5 over the case. This is a little bit simpler, basically. Still comfortable, but a little bit simpler. But something I didn't understand about this transmission was why on earth we have this shit right here. But then he told me it's it's like creeper gears as well as normal gears. I kind of talked to this tractor, you know. This was the high and low, and you push this one forward and backwards to change, you know, between the, you know, the normal range kind of thing that you usually just press a button to change in the New Holland. But he told me actually this is a H pattern gear stick actually. No, it's actually four. Yes, it's quite a lot of gears, this tractor, to be completely honest. Yes, four power shifts in each of the, you know, the four manual gears there. Plus, you can shift that one into low or high, and then you know, that's four power shift in those four different gears as well. So, how many gears is that? So 4, 8, 16. This is 32 gears then, right? Yes. 32 gears, I think. Yeah, 16, yeah. 32 gears, I think, is in this tractor. I was in the beginning just thinking it was a 16 by 16, but it's actually a 32 by 32, so it's quite cool. Apparently you don't get a creeper on the electrocommand gearbox on the New Holland. So of course there's an advantage of this tractor though. But yeah, I learned something new then, I didn't know that. I was thinking this was a 16 by 16 as well. But hey, I learned something new. But I didn't have Steyr tractors, only Case and New Holland. I don't really sell too much Steyr up here, because I've never seen one in real life. Because I know they exist, you know. And the modern ones are basically just, I want to say cases, but yet again though, Case is technically a lot of things from Steyr, so don't really know. Maybe I have seen Steyr since I've seen cases, and the most cases today have Steyr concepts in them, if I don't remember wrong. But anyways, I think this is enough for today. I yammer more about tractors and stuff in the next episode. At least we got done something this episode. And next episode, I think we're gonna try to find all the bloody gold coins. Just for fun, because I don't really like looking at that. Plus, I can show you folks where you find them all. So yeah, spoiler alert. But I really want to see if it actually is a well, or whatever you call it again, to put all the coins inside. So we maybe, you know, can get a lot of money. We have to see. It'd be nice though. But anyway, that's a nice view. Ooh, the moon. Stars coming out as well. Better go to bed then. Yeah, we see you folks in the next episode. So yeah, have a nice day. Bye.